today, Legoland is reopening its gates.
The park has been shut down for 2 months now because of the pandemic. And David Martin is joining us live this morning, where they are very excited to get those bricks moving again. Hey there, David.
Indeed. Good morning, Amy. Hello, Bob. This is a sight that is quite welcoming. Wouldn't you agree? Look at the line developing outside the gate there. That's when rope drop is 10 a.m. and Legoland Florida officially opens to the public after being shut down for 2.5 months. And the general manager of Legoland Resorts here joins us this morning, Rex Jackson. Rex, good morning to you.
Good morning and welcome.
Thank you. What do you think of the scene behind us?
This is fantastic. The music is playing. The guests are coming in. We've got smiles on kids' faces and the joy is getting ready to start. We couldn't be happier.
Goosebumps indeed. All right, tell us how much of the resort is opening today.
We're actually opening almost all of the resort. So we'll be opening our park, our water park, and two of our hotels, including the brand new Pirate Island Hotel as well.
You got reservations for the Pirate Hotel tonight?
Oh, we do. We've already welcomed our very first guest in this morning.
Great. Now, inside the park, are all the rides open?
Yes, we'll be operating all of our rides today. In addition, many of our shows are going to be open. We'll have our retail shops and our restaurants open as well. So we are going to be a fully operating theme park, just with a little bit different operating environment compared to what we've seen in the past.
And that difference starts right at the gate. Tell us about some of the procedures we're going to see when we enter.
Yes, of course. One thing that we're going to be doing differently compared to the past is temperature checks. So we'll be asking all of our guests to go through temperature checks prior to entry. We'll also be providing all of our guests with face masks and encouraging their use throughout their visit to Legoland Florida Resort. And then, of course, we're going to have social distancing measures that we'll be using throughout the resort as well. So we've put together a comprehensive health and safety program for the reopening of our resort today.
What would happen if I were walking from the car to the gate and I were somewhat overheated from the hot Florida sun? It's warm today.
Yes.
And my temperature check was, let's say it's 100. That's not good, obviously. So what do you do with someone like me who's hot?
Yeah, well, we're going to be able to take you away to a shaded area, an air-conditioned area as well, if needed, and be able to let you cool down for a few minutes and then be able to retake your temperature, but also using a regular thermometer at that point in time, too, which will be much more accurate in terms of their measurements also.
And so at what temperature will you send people packing home?
So 100.4 degrees will be the temperature that, unfortunately, you wouldn't be able to be admitted to Legoland Florida Resort today, and we would invite you to come back and enjoy our resort another day.
And you've been testing this temperature testing thing for a while now, haven't you?
Well, not just testing, because we've been using it for our employees now for a little over a week as well. So not only will every guest be temperature checked upon their arrival, but everybody at the resort, whether that be a model citizen, what we call our employees, also our contractors, and then also our guests. So we are looking to provide a safe environment for everybody that comes into our resort, both our guests as well as our employees.
Well, it's not an if, it's certainly a when it rains. What do you do to keep people from clustering inside the park?
Well, we have a number of spaces. The good thing about Legoland Florida is we're not a small park. We actually have a very large park, and we have two hotels as well up here at the entrance. So we've put together plans that we're going to be able to allow guests to use restaurants, retail shops, queue lines in some of our rides. We have several indoor rides as well that are going to continue to operate even when a rainstorm comes in. So we feel confident that we'll have the space to be able to socially distance even when the Florida rainstorms come in.
Hours today?
Hours are 10 to 5 for the park and 12 to 4 for the water park.
So they are abbreviated for now. Those will expand, I presume, once the summer progresses.
Yeah, we're all learning a lot these days as we reopen, and we're going to look forward to be able to expand our hours as the coming days and weeks progress through the summertime period.
Well, for all the families watching this morning, I will give a hearty thank you to you for opening up. Lots of people are climbing the walls with their children, looking for something to do. This couldn't be a more perfect recipe, wouldn't you agree?
Oh, 100%. It is going to be a bricktastic day at Legoland Florida Resort, as we like to say.
All right, Bob and Amy, what do you say? After the show, want to come down and let off some steam and build something with me?
I would love to. Legoland.
Not going to hear from the kids anymore. There's nothing to do today. Oh, yeah, there is. Legoland back open. Thanks, David.
Thanks, David.
And, of course, more theme parks are going to start reopening this week. Universal Studios, Islands of Adventure, and Volcano Bay. They will open to the public on June the 5th. The 3rd and the 4th will be to anyone staying at the hotels. SeaWorld and Aquatica, they plan on reopening on June the 11th. And then Disney will start its reopening process on July 11th with the Magic Kingdom and the Animal Kingdom first, and then followed by Epcot and Hollywood Studios on July the 15th.